Let's do some hands-on activity on the concept which we have learned so far. Okay.
Okay.
So we are going to integrate the HRMS system with our OIM, and then we will do some practical activities in order to learn the reconciliation concept. Okay.
Okay.
Now, what are the high level steps? Now, as I told you that the HRMS system and OIM both are two different types of system, right? So,
yes.
In order to make the communication, in order to establish the communication between two different systems, we need to install the connector who is going to act as a third party, okay, who is going to translate the things. Then, first, we are going to use in this complete module, we are going to use the GTC, that is Generic Technology Connector.
Technology connector, yes.
Okay. In this connector, we are going to create the connector. We will feed the data using flat file, means we are going to use the flat file concept here. And then we will demonstrate the use case like trusted source and the target source reconciliation. Okay.
Okay.
Then before going to start the things, let's understand the GTC. Let's first understand about GTC, how it is going to work.
Okay.
And what is it? Now, this is the complete architecture about Generic Technology Connector.
Okay.
Just have a look into this. Now, we have target system, we have OIM, right?
Okay.
So, using GTC, yes, we can provision the users, means we are propagating the user from OIM to target system, or else we can reconcile, which is completely opposite of provisioning. We can reconcile the user from target system to OIM.
System to OIM. Yes.
OIM. Now, when we are going to reconcile the user from target system to OIM, how the transport is going to happen? Means in reconciliation, we are going to, we have three different concepts in GTC for reconciliation of data. The first is reconciliation transport provider, the second is reconciliation format provider, and the third one is validation provider. So first, let's understand about the transport provider. The transport provider, the method or this transport provider is used to transfer the record contained in the flat file. Okay. This transport provider is going to help us that at which place or at which location the file is located. Now the format provider is going to help us that what sort of file we are using, how the schema or how the file is going to be look like, or what is the skeleton of the file. This is defined by format provider. And then we are going to put some validation. Validation in the sense we are going to see whether the data which is coming from the flat file is correct or not. We are going to validate the data.
Okay.
Okay. Now this is the for the reconciliation. Similarly for provisioning, we are going to define that how we are going to provision the user to the target system, the format provider, and then the transport provider. So we will look both the things. Let's start with the first one. So if you see, reconciliation transport provider is responsible for moving the reconciled data from target system to OIM.
Yes.
And reconciliation format provider, this provider passes the message received from the target system into the data structure that can be understood by OIM engine.
Okay.
Okay. The first one is going to be responsible for moving the reconciled data from target system to OIM. The second one is going to pass the data in such a way that OIM will understand that this data is going to depict this meaning.
Okay.
Okay. Similarly, we have validation provider. This provider validate any data received before passing it to OIM. Means we are going to put some filter that the data which we are going to receive is correct or not. We can put some validation and all.
Okay.
Now, similarly in concept, in the part of provisioning, we have provisioning format provider. That is, this provider convert OIM provisioning data into the format that is supported by the target system. Similarly, we are doing the same for reconciliation format provider. We are converting the data in such a way or passing the data in such a way that OIM will be able to understand. But when you are talking about the provisioning, means you are propagating the data to the target system. So you need to pass the data in such a way that the target system would be able to understand, because you are inserting that data to the target system, right?
Yes.
Similarly, we have provisioning transport provider. The provisioning, this provider carries the provisioning message received from the provisioning format provider to the target system. Means how the transport, let's say when you are trying to send or provision a user to the target system, you need some acknowledgement, right? That whether the operation which OIM tries to perform was successful or not. So this thing is going to be done from the transport provider.
Okay.
Okay.
Got it.
Now let's do the hands-on. So I hope you have a system already with you.
Yes.
Okay. Let me log in. Let me close all the things. Now, first we need to check whether all the servers are up and running or not. Okay.
Okay.
And if you want to know about the server start and stop, or you have already aware about how to start and stop the servers.
Yeah, I'm already aware of.
Okay. Then I'm going to skip this part. Okay. And let's start the hands-on. In order to depict the scenario, first what we need to do, we need to create a flat file.
Okay.
Right. Which is going to contain all the data for us. So
okay.
Are you aware about how much comfortable you are with Linux commands and all?
Yeah, I'm 50% comfortable. So.
50% comfortable. So you are aware about the small basics commands, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So what I am going to do, I am first going to create a folder. Okay.
Okay.
Where in that folder I am going to put all my HR. All my flat file. Okay. So I'm going to create the folder called HRMS.
Okay.
Okay. And the location is home Oracle HRMS. I have created a folder over there. Now, let me create a file. Gedit home Oracle HRMS. hrfeed.csv. Let me create a file.
Okay.
Okay. Let me just copy the content because I have already created a file in past. Let me simply copy the content.
Oracle.
No, actually this path is completely different.
Okay.
Okay. I have created the file in some other location. Let me copy it and let me paste it over here. Let me give Babu one. The login I am going to give as Babu one. The first name is Babu and the last name is M. Then your email ID I am putting as Babu at the red this, and I'm putting your organization as, just a moment, let me just show you all the things from the scratch.
Okay,
let me remove all the things. So what I am doing here, I have in the flat file, means the HRs are going to feed this information. Okay,
okay.
The login, the first name, the last name, the email, the organization. Okay,
Okay.
so for you the login is going to be Babu1, first name is Babu, the last name is M, the email ID is babu@example.com, and the organization is Generate Users.
Okay.
Okay, let me save it. So I have created a file for the flat file, means HRs are going to feed or HRs are going to generate this file. Okay.
Okay.
Now, as per the OIM, we need to feed that information to Oracle Identity Manager, right?
Okay.
In order to do that, what we need to do, as we saw in the presentation, that the first step is to create the connector, right?
Okay.
In order to create the connector, what you need to do, you need to first log into the sysadmin console.
Okay.
Okay. Now, let me log in as GelSysADM. I have logged in. Now, in the under the provisioning configuration, you will be able to see generic connector. Click on that.
Yes.
Then click on create. Now, okay. I want to do this as a trusted source reconciliation. So I have selected trusted source. Now for me, the transport provider is a shared drive, means the data is kept in the drive, right? That's why I have selected as a shared drive. And the format provider is a CSV file.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Let me give the name as HRMS. HRMS1. Okay. I've given the name as this. Now I'm not going to do any provisioning activity. I'm just going to depict the reconciliation scenario as of.
Reconciliation. Okay.
So I've selected reconciliation. All the things are done. Click on next. Continue. Now here is staging directory, means where you are going to keep your data, in which directory you are going to keep your data. So we have kept our data in the location. Let me close it.
Okay.
We have kept our data in cd/home/oracle. And here the name was HRMS, right?
Yes.
So we have kept our data in this location. Let me copy it. You need to provide that where your data is being kept. I provided.
Okay.
Now, staging directory. Staging directory for multi-valued data. So we are not going to use multi-valued attribute as of now. Okay. Whenever it is required, we'll see in the advanced part that where this thing is going to be used. Okay.
Okay.
Now, archiving directory. Archiving directory will say that once your data has been processed, to which location you want to move that file. Let's say HRs have provided you 15 or 20 CSV file. Okay. Now, once all the 20 CSV files will be processed by OIM, you want to move those files to some other location that these files are marked as completed. Right? So here in the archiving directory, it means that the files which are processed by OIM, then the OIM system will move those files to a particular location.
Okay.
So where do you want to move those files? You can put your location as per your requirement. I have put archived. Means inside HRMS system, we have the file named HRMS1, HRFeed1, HRFeed2, something like that. Once those files will be processed, then I want to move those files in the archive directory or archive folder.
Okay.
Now, file prefix. File prefix means that your file name is start with which name?
HRFeed.
HRFeed. So in the next HRFeed1, HRFeed2, HRFeed3, in this way the sequence is going to come. Okay.
Okay.
So for me, it's HRFeed. Let me copy it. So file prefix is going to be HRFeed. Okay.
Okay.
Now the specified delimiter. How we have specified the delimiter, how each field is different or separated by other field. We used comma, right? We used comma in the flat file. If let me open the flat file once again. If you see, we have separated the each field with a comma.
Okay.
So we need to specify the delimiter edge, comma.
Okay.
Up to this part is clear?
Yeah.
Clear. Now, file encoding means how your file is going to be encoded. For us, it's UTF-8. Now, there is two different things. Encoding means file encoding or character encoding. It's a term used in many of the product, be it a Oracle database, be it a Microsoft MS, Microsoft server, or any place. This term is very much popular, character encoding. It means that in all over the world, we are going to use several languages. In China, people used to write, or their mother tongue is China, and their government is also going to use the Chinese language. They didn't allow any other language. Similarly, if you went to Vietnam, they have the Vietnamese language. If you went to German, they have German language. And people are going to use their own language, right? So, in a database, you cannot say the HR that, boss, you are not allowed to fill the data in some other language. You are forced to fill only data in English language. You cannot force like this, right? So UTF-8 is an encoding mechanism which will allow the OIM system to process the data which is coming in very different languages.
Okay.
If you put the language or character set encoding as CP1251, then this connector is only going to allow you to use a flat file which is only written in English language. It is not going to process any file which is written in some other language. But if you put as UTF-8, then it is going to use all the files which is written in English, Japanese, German, Spanish, any language. We are going to use UTF-8, and in most of the organization, they are going to use UTF-8 only. Now, what is the reconciliation type? There are two different types of reconciliation, full and incremental. Since this is a flat file, we are going to use the full reconciliation. Full reconciliation means we are going to process the entire data of the file.
Okay.
I will show you the incremental when we will do, or when we will perform the same activity via the database.
Okay.
So I have selected full, click on continue. Now, once you click on continue, you will come up with this picture. This is how the picture will look like. Now, let me just tell you what are all the things. As I told you that the file is coming from a flat file, right?
Yes.
From flat file, we are moving the data to OIM, right?
In between
that, we have reconciliation engine. The reconciliation engine is going to validate the data which you are passing, the first thing. Second thing, let's say in source file or in the HRMS system, we have login, we have first name, we have last name. The names are different, but in OIM system, there might be some different name or convention which we are using. The attribute name might differ, but the value which they are going to hold may be the same. So we need to do some mapping for that, right?
Okay.
So for that, what we need to do? Up to this part is clear, or am I going too fast?
Yeah, clear.
Okay. Now let's say I want to put in the login part, I want to put a validation here. Okay. I want to put that it is required. Okay, because you cannot create any user without the employee ID or employee number. Right, so I am giving it the login as the mandatory attribute in order to process the data.
Okay.
Now we have the option of create mapping with without transformation, create mapping with concatenation, create mapping with translation. So I will show you that at which places we are going to use this. Let me just do it with the first one, create mapping without transformation means I am not transforming the data which is coming from the flat file. I am keeping the data as it is.
Okay.
Now click on continue. Now, as you can see, the data set is coming from the HRMS system and it is going to fill them. There are lots of fields to which you want to map. It is mapped as login.
Okay.
Now, one thing which we need to do, that is validation. We need to put some validation. If you want to put some validation, click on continue. Where we are going to put some validation. Now, as you can see, specify validation.
Okay.
Now, I want that this particular login field, which is provided in the HRMS file, should not be blank or null. So there are lots of options available over there. Let me select is not blank or null. Let me add it. Click on continue. Click on close. So I have put a validation in the login that the data which is coming from the flat file, this should not be null.
Okay.
After this is clear?
Yeah, from the login HRMS 1 to you are using the data bytes as string, whatever the data we are using from the HRMS 1.
Mm-hmm.
So it is coming to the OAM, same data coming to here, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, let's map the things with OIM. This is the OIM user field. Now, I want email ID should be mapped with the email ID which is coming from the source file.
Okay.
Okay. So, in order to do that, click on this button, edit. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here, I don't want create mapping without transformation. I don't want any transformation at all.
Okay.
Click on continue. Now, select the field which you want to map with this.
Okay.
I want to map with email. Click on continue. Click on close. As you can see, this email is mapped with email
Got
ID
it.
Of OIM system.
Got it. Yeah.
Okay. Similarly, the first name is going to mapped with the first name. Where is my first name? Before that, let me map the user login.
Okay.
Here I am selecting matching only. If you see matching only, because this is the mandatory attribute for me.
Okay.
This is the primary. So you have to put always the user mapping or you have to put always the user login as matching only part. You have to select this.
Okay.
Okay. Now click on continue. Again, select with login, continue, close. As you can see, login has been mapped with user login.
User login. Okay.
Okay. Now we are going to map the other attributes as well. Let's say I want to map the display name should be. Let's say I want to map display name.
Mm-hmm.
For that, let me just do one thing. Click on exit. I am going to add one more thing here. I am going to name the field as display name.
Okay.
Okay. I have given the name and create mapping with concatenation. Now how the display name looks like? Most of the cases, or most of the times, it is the concatenation of first name and last name.
Okay.
Right? So in the flat file, we are mentioning the first name and last name. So we can utilize those data in order to concatenate and build up a new one.
Okay.
Agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So what I am doing, I am giving the field name as display name. I am creating a new field here, which is not coming from the flat file. But it is going to fetch the data from the flat file. How? Let's see. So I've selected create mapping with concatenation. Click on continue. Now, what is the input number one? Input number one, I want to keep it as first name.
Okay.
Okay. And the input number two, I want to keep it as
last name. Okay.
Click on continue. Click on close. As you can see, I am using a transformation here, which is taking the first name and last name and mapping it and passing that data to display name. Now, once I have the data in my display name, what I can do, I have to map it from here. Where is display name? Are you able to see it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's already
this one, right?
Yes.
Let me click on continue. Let me select the display name from this field. Continue, close. Display name is mapped. Okay. Similarly, we have organization. Let me click on organization. Let me create mapping without transformation. Continue. Select the organization. Continue and close it. Similarly, we have first name. Click on first name. Continue. Select the first name. Continue and close it. Similarly, we have last name. Select it. Continue. Select the thing. Continue and close it. Now we are almost done, but whenever you are going to create a user in OIM, you must mention that whether the user is full time or whether the user is contractor, all this information needs to be mentioned. But I am not passing this information from here. As you can see, I am not passing the information from here. Now, in order to do so, what we need to do, Babu, just give me a minute. Sorry for that.
Yeah,
just a minute.
Yeah, no problem.
Now, you need to mention two different things, that is whether the employee is full-time or whether the employee is an end user or he is an admin user. So we need to map two different things as well. Babu, are you there?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So for that, we need to create two more fields in the reconciliation staging. That is one field is employee type. Okay. Click on continue, and I want to pass a value, a hard coded value in this way, in this part. Okay, we can also pass the value from the flat file.
Okay,
so I'm going to pass the value as full time. Click on continue, click on close. As you can see, this is taking the value full time, it is a hard coded value. Now, select again. Now I want to provide the user type. Click on continue. The user type I want to provide as end user. Continue. Now close it. Now we need to do the mapping for employee type as well as we need to do the mapping for user type, right?
User. Yes.
Now in order to do the mapping for employee type needs to be mapped with the employee type of user.
Okay.
Okay. And the user type needs to be mapped with the user type of user.
Okay.
So in order to map the employee type, user type, let me select it. Continue. Here you will be able to see two different things. Continue. User type is mapped with user type. We have one left, that is employee type.
Okay. Employee type.
Where is my employee type? Are you able to see employee type?
No, actually. Yeah, employee number is here, but
employee type would also be there. Type. Just a moment. Okay, so in OIM 11GR2 pass set 3, the employee type has been replaced with the role. Okay, so we need to map this with role.
Okay.
So I forgot that employee type is going to map to its role. Now all the things have been mapped. Click on close. You can see this. Now the name of the connector we have provided as HRMS1. Click on save. Now once you are going to save the thing, what it is going to do, it is going to create a scheduler for you. A scheduled task will be created with HRMS1. Okay.
Okay.
Let me close it. And in order to view the scheduler, what you need to do, first let me check whether Babu1 exists in OIM or not.
Okay.
Okay. Let me close the file. In order to see a user detail, what you need to do, you need to go to Identity Console. As I told you that all the user information and all the information or all the access detail which user want to fetch, he should have to come to Identity Console.
Okay.
Click on Manage. I will navigate through all those options. Don't worry about that. Okay.
Okay.
Click on Manage. Click on Users. Now let me search for the user login, that is your user login. As you can see, there is no user exist with your name. Okay.
Yes.
Now come to the system administrator console. Select the scheduler which is coming over here. Okay. Inside the system configuration, you will be able to see scheduler. Now the name of the connector which we have given was HRMS1. Okay.
Okay.
Now, if I am going to search for that connector, HRMS1, let me see whether HRMS1 name exists here or not. The HRMS1 GTC has been created. Okay. Now, let me enable the thing. Let me run now. If everything went well, you will see the success message. Okay. And click on the event management. As you can see here, event management, search. You can see HRMS1 is there, selected, creation succeeded.
Okay, got it.
Okay, a new user has been created. Now, if you see, login was mapped with user login OIM. Okay, that is Babu1. First name is Babu, which is mapped with first name. Last name is M, which is last name. Now here, just see the display name. Display name is Babu M, which is the concatenation of first name and last name. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now let's come to the self-service console. Let me search Babu1 once again. Is it here?
Yes.
Okay. Select it. Now, as you can see, all the details has been populated here for Babu1.
Okay.
And here you see the user type is full-time employee.
Okay.
Is it clear? You can populate all those fields from the file.
Yeah.
There are lots of fields. Okay. You can populate all those fields. Now, I hope this flat file is now clear for you.
Yes, clear for me.
Completely? Agree with me?
Yeah, completely clear for me. But thing is, like, I don't know how to open the flat file from my system. So, can you just...
What you need to do, you need to create a file. So, for file creation, you can use the gedit command. Okay. Did you create the folder?
No, I haven't worked on till now reconciliation this like this.
Okay, so after the class, just what I want you, go through the video, okay?
Okay.
And also, if you are not aware about the commands, so I have not used any high level of command, okay?
Yes.
I used very basics commands, which are essential for every user who is going to join the course. And the commands, in this way, the flat file is going to work. Now here, if you see, we can go through two options in the reconciliation transformation. The first option was without transformation, and the second option was with concatenation, right?
Okay.
But in that place, there is three different options. If you see, it contains three options. Let me just open it. Let me go to administrator. Again, click on connector, generic connectors. Okay, let me search the connector in this time. HRMS1, edit parameter. Click on continue. Now here, in this part, if I click on the display name, there are three different options for everyone. Create mapping without transformation, create mapping with concatenation,
And
create mapping with translation.
translation.
Okay, we use the first two options. The first one is not
Okay.
going to modify anything. The second one is going to modify or going to concatenate two values. And the
Okay.
third one is going to do something else. Okay.
Okay.
What it is going to do? Just do it at your own. Let me just tell you the concept. Let's say I
Okay.
want to transform the data, something I have the requirement, something like we are going to use some code, okay, in order to see whether the user is a full-time employee or whether the user is a contractor. For that, the HRs are going to use some numeric value. One correspond to full-time, two correspond to the contractor. Let's something like
Okay.
this. Okay. So in the
Yeah.
HRMS file, we are going to put the value 1 and 2.
Okay.
Okay. But when we are going to reconcile the user to OIM system, the OIM system will automatically understand that one correspond to contractor and two correspond to full-time employee.
Okay.
Okay. For that, obviously, if you are going to say that OIM will understand, then OIM should look that value from somewhere. That one correspond to this and two correspond to this. You should store that value somewhere in OIM. Then only OIM will be in a position to understand all those things. Agree with me?
Okay. Yeah.
So for that, there is a concept of lookups. Okay, lookups are going to store the property file, which is used by OIM in many places. Not only for this purpose, but for many purpose, lookups are going to be used. So let me just do one thing. Let me just show you that example as well. That is the extension of this particular example. Okay,
Okay.
let me close it. Let me just do one thing. Here I am mapping the employee type as full-time and something, right?
Full-time.
Let me
Yes.
add one more attribute here. As I told that we are going to take the employee type from a file. Okay. Let me close it. You can see the flat file should contain six different mapping. Okay. Now here, this employee type should map with this employee type. So what I am going to do? I am going to do without trans with translation. Okay, continue. What is the input? From where the input is coming? The input is coming from the source file, that is employee
Yes.
type. So I need to select the employee type from here, and the lookup code name from where you want to fetch the data or the modification is going to happen. Let me show you this content of this lookup. This is a lookup which is created in OIM system. Okay, let me just open it. In order to see, show you the content, go to self-service console. Okay. Click on lookups. A window will open up. Let me search it. A lookup is here.
Yes.
Now, let me just show you the value. As you can see, inside this lookup, we have two values. The value is, if you see, meaning is the code is 1. If 1 is coming, it means OIM will understand as full time. If the value come as 2, OIM will understand it as contractor.
Contract.
Okay,
Okay.
so in the flat file, we are going to use these codes instead of writing the things, and we will see how the translation is going to work.
Okay.
Okay, in order to create the lookup, you need to take help from Design Console. I will show you how you are going to create it. Before that, just let me show you how the things are going to work. Let me cancel it. Now here, what I am going to do, I am going to select it. It's already opened up. Employee type, click on continue. Let me close it. Specify the parameter. Create mapping with translation, continue. Default name is employee type. And the lookup name is this one. Click on continue, click on close. Okay. As you can see, this thing is looking like this. I am putting a lookup in front of this one. Now, the remaining mapping will be remain the same because we are passing the different data from the source file, right?
Yes.
So we need to create a source file based on our requirement, okay? And this time the flat file should contain 6 different attributes. Earlier it was containing 5. Now this time it should contain 6 attributes. Now, let me close it. Let me save the configuration. Let me save it.
Okay.
Now in the meanwhile, let me, and one more thing I want to show you, home, Oracle, HRMS. Here we have earlier created the file. Okay.
Yes.
If you see, we are not able to see any file over here. The file should not be visible over here. The file should be automatically moved to archived. Just a moment. Okay, the archive folder is not created. That's why the system was unable to move the things to the archive folder. So we need to create an archive folder here. So in order to create the archive folder, let me, because there we have mentioned this directory, right?
Yes.
Now let me just copy HR feed to archived.
Okay.
Okay, I have copied the thing and let me remove all the files from here. RM remove file HR feed.
Okay.
Now there's one more file, RM HR feed. Now there is no file at all. Okay. Now we are going to create a new file in this location. For that, what I am going to do, I am going to copy the file from the archive folder to here. If you see, just a moment, archived HR feed to here. Now I have a file here. Now I am going to modify the file as per our requirement. So in order to create a file, we are going to use the gedit command. In order to modify it, we are again going to use the gedit command and then the file name. The file has opened. Now here we have mentioned one more attribute, that is employee type. Right?
Yes.
In this way, we have written the employee type in that file. Now let me give the value as 1, or it was capital. You need to mention the same thing. Let me just do one thing. Let me close it. Let me open the configuration once again. Search the connector, HRMS1, edit. Click on continue. It was written as E small t capital. Let me close it.
Yes.
E small t capital. Okay. I am putting some other value, that is I am placing Babu 2. Okay. Babu 2. And the employee type is H1. And then I am again going to put another user with Babu 3. Okay. And the email ID for this one is Babu 3. Okay. But employee type I am putting as 2.
2. Yeah.
Okay, let me save it. Let me close it. One file is going to be edited. RM. Let me. we have only one file here. Okay, if you want to see the content, I will show you the content. Shit, it has rewritten the file. Let me just edit the file once again. So you can use any command for editing, whether vi or anything, as per your requirement.
Okay,
so I'm going to use the same. Char feed 1. Let me open it. I'm going to use the same thing here. Employee type, this is 1, this is 2. Here I am going to put as 3, 2. Let me save it. File, close. Okay, so I have created the file. Okay, now let me just see the content of HR feed. Let me remove this file. Now if you want to see the content, let me just show you the content, whether we are putting the right thing or not. Yes, the file is up to date, right? We have two entries, Babu2 and Babu3. One is going to be act as a full time and the other one is going to be act as a contractor. So let's try to run the reconciliation once again.
Okay.
So come to this is my job detail. Let me refresh it. Enable it. Job already enabled. Let me close it. Actually, whenever you are going to save the, whenever you are going to configure or do any modification in a GTC, the scheduler will went to disabled state. Okay.
Okay.
So you need to enable it once again. If I open it, if you see it is went to disabled, that's why enable option is available. So enable it and then okay. Click on run now. Once you click on run now, it is succeeded. Click on event management.
Yeah.
Click on this. As you can see, Babu2 and Babu3, two users are here.
Okay.
Now let's see whether the things which we have done is correct or not. Babu2 got a full time and Babu3 should be contractor.
Okay.
Contractor. Let me just see the same thing in OIM. Is it, am I making some sense?
Yes, it's clear for me.
Okay, Babu2, if I open it,
yeah, it's getting ended details. Babu2,
is that getting full time employee?
Yes,
let me open Babu3. It is getting the contractor.